Welcome to a new edition of the Neon Jazz Interview Series with Kansas City Hammond B3 organist and member of Guitarlation, Ken Lovern. Their new double live CD from the Green Lady Lounge is out and the reviews are glowing. This is a very groove-oriented, hard-hitting, funky jazz act, and they like it that way. This album features compositions from three of the band members, with Danny Embry's tunes making up the majority of the selections. The group has been playing Thursday nights at the Green Lady Lounge in Kansas City for years now, so they are well-versed, and this recording is one of those great nights they played. Along with Danny and Ken, it features Brian Baguette on the other guitar and Todd Strait on the drums. Ken opened up about all things related to the CD and the band, so please get to know him, this band, and dig this interview, my friends.
So, Ken, thanks for taking a minute out to talk about this live recording from the Green Lady. I appreciate it.
I'm excited to be here. Thanks for the conversation, Joe.
My pleasure, man. So I love this band. It's a power act. I think the first time I heard about it or saw it was at the Prairie Village Jazz Fest, and now we've culminated with a double live CD set from the Green Lady. Talk to me a little bit about the beginnings of this band and how everything started.
We had been doing a variety of groups at Green Lady Lounge, but OJT was one of my core groups there. In conversations with our guitarist, Brian Baguette, and John Scott, the club owner, and various people, and actually Todd Strait, the drummer, we started talking about wanting to have a rhythm guitar player to play behind Brian Baguette. And then the idea came up, well, Danny Embry's a great rhythm guitar player. And Brian Baguette laughed because he's like, well, yeah, but he's like a great soloist. Because, you know, he's not going to be the rhythm player. And so then we kind of came to think, well, we'd have, you know, a two-guitar band featuring both guitarists. And that's sort of how the conversation started that ended up in Guitarlation, was originally thinking of it as a rhythm guitarist, and then it just turned pretty quickly into just a two-guitar band featuring both the guitarists.
And you guys have a regular gig every Thursday, so the tightness of this unit, the conversation you have, just has to get better and richer as time goes on.
It's really nice to be able to play, you know, consistently, because rehearsals and preparation of material is great, but there's just no substitute for music on a gig. You know, different things happen when you're playing before an audience. You know, getting the opportunity to play original music in front of an audience on a weekly basis is really great. And this recording, really, it just came out last month. You know, it came out February. It's just now turning March. This recording was actually made pretty early in the band's history, back in 2017. We'd been together for about a year then. The tunes have evolved since then and are a little different. I still like this recording a lot. It still sounds really fresh to me. The band has evolved. We've already made another recording. There really is no substitute in my mind for just getting to play, especially when you're trying to do live original music. You know, getting to play it on a weekly basis is just great.
And this is a major label release. You guys are always packing the Green Lady. This just has to feel good to have this out. And what's kind of the reception been from everybody so far?
Well, it's still pretty new. We got a good review from Bill Brown. He's done a couple of writings about it and got a unreservedly positive response from him, which was nice. We've gotten some good responses from some of the radio people. We're promoting it to jazz radio all over the country. We've gotten some good responses so far from the jazz radio people, you know, saying they'll play the record. One guy was listening to it on Valentine's Day with his wife and was saying it was one of the best funk records he's ever heard. He was going to play every track on it. And so that was nice to see. I'll know more about that actually in a couple of weeks as it really starts to hit jazz radio. I'll see more responses from the DJs.
You know, the one thing that's always evident when you walk in the Green Lady is, I always joke around, it's kind of the vampire lair, and there's always so much life going on. You know, I always ask musicians when they're coming to Kansas City, if you come and you play at a venue, and I always envision the Green Lady, what do you want to give the crowd? But I know what you guys give, and I know what you guys are doing. So my question is this. When I come in and I watch you guys and I sit down and I have a drink and I'm enjoying what's going on there, I know the feeling it gives me. But I want to ask you, what do you want the listener that gets this CD or comes in and sees you live and picks this CD up to get from this experience that they have over and over again?
Well, I think there's something special about having two guitars. Because it's a live record, you know, you can kind of hear that experience going on where the guitars are interacting, they're feeding off each other. I think that experience is only enhanced when you're there live, especially if you're up close. You can hear what's going on, but also you can see the musicians cueing off each other. You can see the guitar players checking each other out in terms of, okay, what do you do here? And, you know, they kind of get that fret fireworks going where they kind of egg each other on. And that's really, I think, one of the highlights of this band, music being created in the moment where you've really got four musicians who are all very interested in listening and improvising and responding and supporting each other. You know, we've got Todd Strait on drums, who's, I think, one of the greatest accompanists in the world, you know, in terms of his listening ability, and of course he's got an incredible technical ability, but he just listens so deep into the music, it's like he can hear into the future. The fact that we're all listening and responding to each other and in the moment, that's really, I think, part of what makes the live record appropriate, you know, especially appropriate for this band. And I think the record's a good way to sort of experience that if you've seen us live, and even if you haven't, you know, to have sort of that experience in the recorded area.
I love that answer, Ken. Hey, thanks for taking a minute. It's great. You nailed it. I mean, everything that I was looking for. Ken, thanks for taking a minute out. I love it, man. The thing I still do, maybe this is just dating me in my age, I love putting the CD in the car and driving and just letting it wash over me as the world goes by. And this has been a really, really nice album to listen to in the car. So great work. I look forward to seeing you guys live more with this material. And I appreciate your time today, man.
Thanks so much, Joe. I'm glad you're enjoying it.
Thanks for listening and tuning in to another Neon Jazz interview, where we give you a bit of insight into the finest cats in New York City, Kansas City, and spots all over the world, giving fans all that jazz. And thanks to Ken for his time, music, and stories. If you want to hear more interviews, go to Famous Interviews with Joe Domino in the iTunes Store. Visit NeonJazz at YouTube.com. And for everything Neon Jazz all the time, go to theneonjazz.blogspot.com. Until next time, enjoy the jazz, my friends.
Neon Jazz.